In a series of videos, we are learning HTTP client module. This video is to point out a mistake made in video number 16.3, and I will provide instructions to rectify the mistake in this video. This video number 16.3 was published on 4th January 2023. Whatever shown in the screen is the video that has the mistake. A corrected version of this video number 16.3 is planned to be published on 8th January 2023. If you had viewed the video which recommends to use --defaults option when creating the Angular application, then that is the version with mistake. If you had viewed this video and if you had created the Angular workspace based on this video, then proceed ahead with this video, which contains instructions to rectify this error. If you had viewed the video that does not recommend to use --defaults, then you have viewed the corrected version of the video and the rectification instructions provided in this video is not required, and you can move on to the next video. We sincerely regret the inconvenience caused. Now, I will explain the mistake in that video. The assumption was that --defaults option would create the Angular application with routing, but it does not actually create routing in the Angular application. If you look at my workspace that was created with --defaults option, we can see that app-routing.module.ts file is not generated in src/app folder. Without routing, we cannot implement this example, as we have to navigate between multiple screens and we have to rectify it before proceeding ahead. Now I will mention the steps to rectify this mistake. It is recommended to remove the country folder, which will delete the Angular workspace, and to freshly create a new Angular workspace with routing. If your Angular application is already running, stop the application, then close Visual Studio Code and delete the country folder in File Explorer. Then create a new Angular workspace in the same folder using the command ng:new:country:--style=css:--routing. This command will create the Angular workspace with routing. After successful execution of the command, open the workspace in Visual Studio Code and start the Angular application. Then, as mentioned in the previous video, include the HTTP client module in app.module.ts, and then you can proceed ahead with the subsequent videos to further implement the HTTP client example. This completes all the steps that is required to rectify this mistake. I will be performing these rectification measures in my desktop after publishing this video. We understand that this is a frustrating experience for you and sincerely regret the inconvenience caused.